Despite her impressive resume, acting is just one of the many creative outlets for Rachel Griffiths. She's also an art consultant and a producer. And in an interview with our very own Georgia Love, Rachel talks about all things love, life and passion.
She brought out her inner ABBA fan in Muriel's wedding. Put Rachel Griffiths on the path to Hollywood movie roles and starring in the global TV success, 6 Feet Under.
Don't you throw that ring at me!
But it was here in Australia where her acting career began. And now she's returned to her home country for a revealing new art campaign, No Robe.
Usually when we catch up with you, we're talking about a new film or TV show or something, but you wouldn't be the Rachel Griffiths we know and love if you were predictable, so...
Thanks for that. I'm going to keep to that.
You're going to tell everyone else. Tell me why we're here today.
So we're here at the Olsen Hotel. John Olsen, probably Australia's greatest living artist, and his work is everywhere in this hotel, from the mural when you first walk in. There are 7 hotels in the Art Series hotel chain.
We obviously know you love Melbourne and you're from here,
I'm living here.
What made you decide to move back and why was that important for you?
Look, it's a mix of a lot of things, but definitely we wanted our children to know our parents, and my husband is from Melbourne. So to move back to Australia, not move back to Melbourne, would have been crazy. And it's just, it has been really beautiful. I've been back 4 years. It's been really beautiful to see the relationships develop with their cousins and their parents. And I just think my life would have been very sad if I couldn't witness and share my beautiful parents with my children. So it was simple as that, family.
Being in Melbourne as well can't hurt with your directorial project that you're working on at the moment.
Yeah.
So you've bought Michelle Payne's book and you're turning that into a film. Tell me how that's going and about that.
Beyond humbled and excited that Michelle trusted us with her life story. We're going to Cannes next week, actually, to kick that off. So it's taking longer than I expected, but everything in life does. Getting married took longer than expected. Having kids took longer than expected.
You've called yourself a poor feminist and a poor activist.
No, I said I was lazy in my youth. I think I was lazy, yeah. I think I just assumed that the world was, you know, going to slowly roll for women's equality in one direction. And when you look at the Trump cabinet and you look at 30 male white Republicans over 50 celebrating the rollback of healthcare that is taking maternity health away from women, you know, equal rights begins at health for women, because I know how dangerous it can be if you're not in care. If I had not have been in the best hands in the world, you know, myself and my child would not have made it. But I'm not going to be lazy anymore.
And she's certainly not lazy anymore, backing the marriage equality movement in Australia.
Gay rights and marriage equality are about essential civil rights. You know, how can we be the lucky country if we say, sorry, you're not lucky enough to get married like me? You know, my marriage is the thing I'm most proud of in my life. Really, it's given me so much, and I wouldn't be sitting here today with the kind of sense of love and support that I have if I didn't have that access to that. I'm asking people at the moment, how many images on your phone? People are like, oh, 10,000, or at least. I'm like, 5,000, like 10. I was like, can you recall 5 of those images? And they're like, no. You know, the depressions that you want to see at the end of your life? No. And yet a drawing often will last, you know? You won't forget a drawing that's been done of you.
Is that something that you try to impart on your children as well? Because they're at that, I suppose, tender age, for want of a better term, of, you know, getting caught up in the selfies and social media.
I try to be strict. One of my children has lost the iPad and the phone this week. One for saying she doesn't have it when it was under her covers. So they're a good control device. So I almost like that they're there so that I can use it. And I'm sure that's a lot of parents. It's like, if I don't have an iPad, then what am I going to ban? What's the threat going to be?
That's why we love her. A Hollywood actress, passionate activist, and a down-to-earth mum. Pictures of you.
Will be running until June 15. To find out more, head to artserieshotels.com.au.